It's Ricky Melvin and Charlie Kiss Breakfast right now. We're joined by Rita Ora, the Rockers in the building.
Yes. So, Rita, I talked to us about the single.
Yes,
man.
Thank you for playing it, guys.
Absolutely.
It's kind of just, I didn't actually, it was my personal favorite, but I didn't know what it was going to do. Sia kind of wrote it in LA ages ago.
Wow.
And we just were like, it's my favorite song. That's why I named the tour Radioactive.
Yeah. So you both wrote the song?
Yeah.
How do two people write a song together?
Well, she had the idea initially.
Right.
Yeah. Initially. Yeah. And then I just came in and put a little twang on it. But she's such an incredible writer. A lot didn't have to be done. So.
I was going to say that because she's like written some massive hits.
Yeah, but before Diamonds, like you guys, you know, she's done a lot before that.
Yeah.
Like
yeah.
her solo work and
David Guetta.
Yeah, and she's a like Australia like lover, and it's cool. Yeah.
Now, I want to ask you about the Super Bowl because I read on your Twitter the other day that you was like, if Beyonce and Destiny's Child come out together, I am going to cry.
I cried.
Did you really?
Yeah. I actually cried. Things like that make me so happy that there's still real talent out there. Like that, the fact that someone can hold their own like for 20 minutes on that stage.
On their own as well, a lot of the time.
And to know that I know, I don't want to say it like, yo, I know and everything, but like the fact that I've been honored to be in her presence and know how nice she is.
Yeah, yeah.
That's why I got so emotional.
Yeah.
I think that's beautiful that you actually know her, but you're still so happy to see her perform.
Oh man,
still a fan, right? Still a fan.
Such a fan, always. I got goosebumps just thinking about it.
That's wicked. Now the Brits are coming up. You've been nominated. Congratulations!
Congratulations!
Yeah. Big up,
surely you're gonna win one, right? Surely.
Yeah. I don't know. I'm so scared.
And do you know what? I love it when Rita wins awards because she just goes all out, like. I love watching your acceptance when she jumps around, throws the thing in the air.
I don't care. Everything's coming out. I've got a minute to tell the world what just happened. So I'm just going to be like...
You might not have a minute, though, because if you saw Adele last year, they cut her short to make it quick.
She's amazing. No, I can't. I don't know. I think I would literally... I think I'd cry again.
Now, Rita, in the past, there's been some great performances at the Brits and collaborations. You've
had there has.
Florence and Dizzy, Kylie and Justin Timberlake. Are you performing with anyone?
At the Brits?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What?
Are we gonna get a clue? Because you're not gonna obviously tell us who it is, but do we get at least a clue?
I'm not performing at this year's Brits. I'm only going to sit there. I'm only coming to the show.
If I see you on my TV...
Then you can officially call me a liar, but no, I'm not performing at this year's Brits.
Okay.
I know. I mean, I would love to have performed, but it's okay. Going to the show, having a little party, there's nothing wrong with that.
Fair enough.
That's true. Now, Reese, how long since you got back from Thailand?
Oh, gosh. Oh, I didn't want to come back. I was so sad.
I saw your Instagram
pictures.
I left
like 2 weeks. I think it's been 2 weeks now because I came straight on tour. So, yeah, 2 weeks.
About 2 weeks ago, okay. So you was out there with
Snoop Lion for his new single.
Lion.
Yeah, we shot a video out there.
Now I've got to ask you, what is Snoop like these days?
Oh,
because
man.
Obviously he's changed.
Such a Don.
He's gone from Snoop Dogg to Snoop Lion because he's like got a whole new persona and taken on a whole new thing. What's he like?
He like still crip walks, like.
No way.
If he still crip walk, then you're just ultimate cool. Like he still crip walk to the barbecue and ask for some ribs. He went, I'll show you. He went like this. He went. And you know, he's so tall. And like, you're just so cool.
I'm going to ask you about being compared to other artists. Because we were talking about this on air the other day. And every artist gets compared to someone.
Yeah,
it gets boring.
Does.
But it does
so
get boring. But if you could choose one artist to get compared to, who would you choose?
Oh, if I could choose. I'll be good for Dandy. It would probably be... I don't know, I love Gwen Stefani so much.
I knew you were going to say that.
I know, and our music is like, you know, she's got that cool, rocky kind of vibe. And, you know, she's been my inspiration with the blonde hair and the red lips. I've been saying that openly for ages.
Yeah.
Like, she's the one that made me start it. I even told her myself, actually.
Really?
What did she say?
She went, sweet.
Now, Rita, the other day I was talking about Trey Songz. He was performing in the UK the other day.
Yeah. That just reminds me, every time I think of Trey.
She was having a little moment there.
Every time I think of Trey, I feel like oiled abs.
Well, like, I was saying, if I had a girlfriend, I'd never take her to go and see Trey Songz, right? But I want to flip it on you. I want you to imagine that you've been given free tickets to see Cheryl Cole live in concert. However, your boyfriend at the time loves Cheryl Cole.
Loves
These are
her.
Backstage tickets. And she's going to be performing. Now, would you...
And meet and greet as well.
Meet and greet as well.
And a kiss on the cheek.
And...
And a kiss.
He's Cheryl's type. So he looks like the ex.
So he's light-skinned.
So would you take your boyfriend to go and see Cheryl? Would you give the tickets to him to go with another friend or not mention the tickets at all?
Oh my God, I would take his hand and I would walk in that meet and greet with him and make him have his 2 minute silence with Cheryl. I wouldn't even get involved.
You're a good girlfriend.
Yeah, man.
No, I think it's all about that security thing. Like, you know you're the one, so it's like, you know that you're giving him everything, you know. So it's like, it's what you got to do, isn't it? Why not?
You're a better person than me then.
He just wouldn't go, would you?
I would not go, and she's not going too.
Rita, your Radioactive tour actually runs until February the 13th, which is perfect timing because Valentine's Day is the next day.
I know. Do you want to know the truth?
Yeah.
I'm going to just be honest with you all tonight. Mm-hmm.
She's going to be with me, guys. You can say it, Rita. It's fine. Don't worry.
Do you want to know something? I'm officially going to try speed dating.
Seriously?
Yes, I'm admitting it. Yeah! I'm admitting it.
That's a great idea,
you know
actually.
What? You need to get some advice from Melvin because he's the speed dating king.
Oh, God. What? Did you go every Friday or something?
And Saturday. And Sunday. And Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday.
No, I used to go to one called Traffic Lights.
And oh, really?
Like, yeah, but they had couples there or singles there as well, because if you just want to have a conversation with someone and everyone wears a traffic light, so I think red means, like, no go.
But you still did.
Like, you can't go there.
You can't go there because they're in a relationship. Right. And then Amber's like, they're not too sure. It's a complicated relationship. And green means it's a go.
Really?
It's a go.
It's 100%.